Now, the next sorting technique is the insertion sort. Okay, so as we discussed what is bubble sort, now it is a time to discuss what is insertion sort. Insertion sort is a very simple sorting algorithm in which the sorted array is built one element at a time. The main idea behind the insertion sort is that it inserts each item into its proper place in the final list. Insertion sort is less efficient as compared to the other more advanced algorithms such as quick sort, heap sort, and merge sort. See, now in the case of insertion sort, we are placing the element at a proper place in the final list. Means we are comparing each element with every other element until we will not get the higher element than that particular element. We just keep on doing sorting the list one by one. So for that, we are creating one temp variable. Temp variable, whatever the data which is there in the temp variable, compare with each variable which is there in the sorted list. Now for the insertion sort, we are creating two types of list. First is the sorted list, another is the unsorted list. Every time the element from the unsorted list is compared with the element is there in the temp. Okay, and every time if there is a chances of swapping, then only we can swap the element which is there in the temp, and then we are putting into the list. Otherwise, we are only observe the content and shift the place one behind other, so that they can arrange in ascending order. Now at this stage, you cannot understand what is insertion sort. First of all, you take one example, you observe the example which is given in this slide, then you can understand what is the insertion sort. Now this insertion sort is less efficient as compared with the other more advanced algorithms. Okay, so that is one kind of a disadvantage of the insertion sort. But at this stage, we also understand what are the different, or we have studied what are the different sorting techniques. What is the technique behind the insertion sort? Now see here, the array of values to be sorted divided into two sets. One that store the sorted values and another that stores the unsorted values. So this is very important. There are two arrays. There are two lists, sorted list and unsorted list. The sorting algorithm will proceed until there are elements in unsorted list. Till we not vacant the unsorted list, the sorting continues. Suppose there are n elements in the array, initially element with the index 0, that is assuming the lower bound is equal to 0, or the element which is placed at A of 0 is in the sorted set, rest of all the elements are in the unsorted set. So we are placing that A of 0 value in a temp, and we are considering that one element as a sorted list. So that element is sorted because there is no comparison. One element, no comparison. Other is unsorted list. We compare this element with every other element in an unsorted list. And we keep on searching until we cannot get the proper place to put that particular element which is there in the sorted list. The first element of the unsorted partition has array index 1. During each iteration of algorithm, the first element in the unsorted set is picked up and inserted into correct position in the sorted set. Now let us look at this example. In this example, we have one list which is not at all sorted, that is 39, 9, 45, 18, 81, 108, 54, 72, and 36. Now we have come across different types of pass. Pass 1, pass 2, pass 3, pass 4, pass 5, pass 6, pass 7, pass 8, pass 9. We have two types of patterns, like a sorted pattern and unsorted pattern. The part which is dark and gray is the unsorted pattern. The part which is lighter gray is the sorted pattern. In the previous sorting algorithm also, we are doing the sorting technique. But we are comparing every element with every other element. Then we are moving to first largest index, then second, then third, then fourth, and so on, up to how many elements we have in that particular list. Here we are using a different types of technique, that is of sorted list and unsorted list. So we start with first, that is we start with the element which are there in the A of 0, that is 39. So this 39 is compared with the 9. Now 9 is lesser than 39, as we know. So we are comparing these two and pass the element at a proper place. So first of all, we put a 39 in a temp. Now 39 is compared with the remaining all other unsorted list. Now the first element is 9. Now as 9 is lesser than 39, we are providing the shift, so that 9 is placed at the sorted list and 39 is also placed at the sorted list. Now after whatever the other elements are there that are in an unsorted list, so our first pass is over, because in our first pass only one element in a sorted list, that is 39. Now after the pass 1, it is we are in a position to sort two elements, that is 9 and 39. In pass 2, the sorted list becomes automatically we are adding 45, because in a complete list these three elements are already sorted, that are 9, 39, 45. Again in a pass 3, we got the 4 elements, that is 9, 39, 45, 63 in a sorted list. Now in a pass 4, we are comparing the element 18 with 81. Okay, to understand what is pass 4, please observe pass 3. Now we are putting this 18 into the temp, okay, and suppose consider here t is equal to, here consider t is equal to 18, right? So We are comparing this 18, which is placed in a temp, with every other element which is there in the sorted list. Okay, so as we are putting this 18 into the temp, this position is vacant. So we are shifting the element as we are comparing 18 with 63. Now 63 is greater than 18. So we are putting 63 at a place of 18. Now again we compare 18 with the 45. Then we are comparing 39 with 18. And again we are comparing 9 with 18. So here we understand that 9 is lesser than 18. And 39 is greater than 80. So we can place after 9 the 80. As we are moving every element at the vacant position, so after 9 we get some vacant position over here, and in that we place the 18. Okay, means we are going on searching the element till we can't get the proper position to place that particular element. Now here in the pass 5, we are writing the sorted list and unsorted list. That is 9, 81, 39, 45, 63, 81. Up to that we get the sorted list. After that, we can't get the sorted list. So again, we are putting 108 inside the temp. So now, T is equal to 108. T is equal to 108. So now the position of 108 is vacant, and we are placing elements one by one to that particular position. Now observe the pass 6. In pass 6, we are putting 108 after 81, as we are comparing 81 in the 108. So 108 is greater than 81, so we are putting that 108 in a sorted list. Again, we are comparing the 54 with 108. Now the 54 is putting into the temp. The position of 52 is vacant, so we are shifting all the elements one by one. Now we are in a position to get that the 63 and 54. Now 54 and 63, before that we get one element, that 45 and 54. Now we understand that 45 is lesser than 54, so that we can put the element after 54 and before 63 in a pass 7. We have to find that which element is lesser in that particular element which are there in the temp, and we can put the element after that particular lesser element, or we can say that lower element. So in the pass 7 also we are doing the same thing. We are having a 54. 54 is compared with 63, 81, 108. All are greater than 54, and we get one value, that is 45, which is lower than 54. Because of that, we are putting 54 after 45. Now we get again in the pass 8, we get a sorted list like. Now in the pass 7, we have sorted list like 72 and 36. Now again we are comparing 72 with all other elements, and till we get the smaller elements than 72. So after finding the elements, we are having the position that 63. 63 is the element which is lower than the 72. Then we stop our searching and place 72 after 63. Now we only have the last element, that is 36. Now 36 is again compared with 108. Now position is vacant, so we are shifting the element. Position is vacant, so we are shifting the element 108, then 81, then 72, then 63, then 54, then 45, then 39. Now we are comparing 18 with 63. Now 18 is less than 36, and that's why we put that 36 in the vacant place which is created in the list. Now in this way we can create a sorted array by using insertion sort. In an insertion sort, in an algorithm, only we have to take a temp element. In a temp element, we find the element which is lower than the element which is there in the temp. Once we get the lower element which is there in the temp than the element which is there in the temp, once we get the lower element which is there, which is lower than the element which is there in the temp element, we put that element after the lower element. because we have already the space vacant over there. Why? Because we are taking out that element from the unsorted list and putting into the temporary variable. Because of that, the space is created in unsorted list, and because of that we are shifting every element to the right hand side. And once we get the element which is lower than the element which is there in the temp, we put the element which is there in the temp after that particular lower element. So by using such a technique, such a pass, we are sorting the element with the help of insertion sort. So while writing algorithm, you can write in that particular manner that you are decrementing the counter and you are searching for the record, and then you are putting the value appropriately. So that is the technique that we are using inside the insertion sort. Now this is somewhat explanation of insertion sort, that is, A of 0 is the only element in the sorted list. In pass 1, A of 1 will be placed either after or before A of 0 so that array A is sorted. In pass 2, A of 2 is placed either before A of 0, in between A of 0 and A of 1, or after A of 1. In pass 3, A of 3 will be placed in its proper place. In n-1 will be placed in its proper place to keep it array sorted. To set the element in its proper place, we have to put the element, one element which are there in this unsorted list, into the temporary variable so that the space is created in the complete list. We are shifting the element till we cannot get the element which is lower than the element which is there present in the temporary variable. Now, what are the different advantages of insertion sort? So it is easy to implement and efficient to use on a small set of data. It can be efficiently implemented on data sets that are already substantially sorted. It performs better than algorithms like selection sort and bubble sort. Insertion sort algorithm is simpler than shell sort with only a small trade-off in efficiency. It is over twice as fast as the bubble sort and almost 40% faster than the selection sort. It requires less memory space. It is said to be online, as it can sort a list as and when it receives a new element. So these are all advantages of insertion sort. Okay, so in a bubble sort, we are comparing each element with every other element, but in an insertion sort, we are using a temporary variable, and in that temporary variable, we compare the element which are there in unsorted list. Once we get the lower element than the variable which is there in the temporary variable, then and then only we perform sorting of elements. So this is all about insertion sort. Thank you.